Hello, my name is Jan Sievers Mahon. I'm the Arboretum Director at the Edith J. Carrier Arboretum at JMU. Today I'll be talking with educators and students from the Shenandoah Valley about an enriching program that connects young children with outdoor learning gardens and creates opportunities for intergenerational learning and relationship building with college-age mentors. Dr. Amy Goodall is with the School of Integrated Science at James Madison University. Could you tell me how the program began?
Sure. It began in 2011, and that was a time in which we had some new curriculum developments in my program of geographic science. At that same time, Ann Lintner, the principal of Keister Elementary, had a site where there was a playground. They had removed the playground, and that site was available. And since that time, we have also built a garden at Bluestone Elementary, which is our newest school in Harrisonburg, and we have either built or modified at four other city gardens at schools.
So I'm curious, who created the design for your first garden, and was it a collaborative process?
That very first garden was designed by the capstone students that were seniors within geographic science, and they made the first outline of the garden based on the space that was provided, but also the lengths of students' arms. So they configured how far students could reach into a bed. So the width of the beds were greatly designed by the size of the students. The distances between beds were related to movement within the garden, including for handicap. And also the height of the beds were based on the sizes of the children.
Tell us about some of the plants that you grew there and why you chose them when you decided to create a pollinator garden.
Well, really based it on my interest in wanting to build gardens for butterflies because I wanted to conduct these research projects in capstones to understand butterfly biodiversity. The juniper hair streak, which is a butterfly that requires its caterpillar stage in a woodland, has been seen only at Keister Elementary, and the students like it because it's green. It's a green butterfly. So not only are they learning about a variety of pollinators, they're learning about how the surrounding habitat is affecting what brings things into their garden. And having gardens set up in different school sites, some schools are surrounded by forest. One is surrounded by a golf course. Some have roadways and some are near meadows.
And what kind of pollinator plants did you choose?
One thing that's really good for any garden for children is to think of the five senses. So that's going to be things like coneflowers and phlox and the bee balm. Zinnias and other annuals work really well for different heights of plants, as well as different colors. Marigolds last into the fall. We like dill because dill brings in the caterpillar stage of the black swallowtail. In terms of the vegetables that we planted, that was a voting process with the children.
Oh, well, can you talk about what some of the vegetable choices those kids made?
Sure, they like carrots. That's always number one. Tomatoes and potatoes. Lettuce never scores very high, nor does broccoli. In terms of fruits, strawberries, hands down. We've had them vote on their favorite pollinators as well. Interestingly, the monarch, of course, is always high, and then next is the hummingbird. So they love the ruby-throated hummingbird.
Well, this year has been a particularly difficult challenge because you're only able to garden through March. Besides COVID, what are some of the other challenges that have come up with this project?
The planting is done by everybody, so students of all ages. You know, we have to do things like teach them when they water, they have to water the root. If you say water the flower, they will water the flower. We now have maps for each of the schools so that the school knows where we've been digging and where we've planted seeds, and we know where they've planted, because we have certainly done things like taken out an entire bed of lettuce seeds and not knowing it. Signage is really critical, and that's another thing that's a cooperation often with garden club or the art teacher working with JMU students and elementary students to make signs. And the signs might be as simple as says, this is just planted. It's also things like love our garden.
When I walk into the garden, I see all the other kids playing with each other, looking at the different things in the garden.
When I walk into the garden, it makes me feel happy. I go out there and see 5, 6, 7 species of butterflies. You see the honeybees, but you also see the bigger bees. You see some species of birds and ducks that kind of find home in the Keister Garden is great.
Welcome, Principal Miller. And today, along with you, we have Anna and Micah here to share with us about the gardens. Micah, what is your experience when you spend time in the garden at school?
Something that's really interesting to me in the garden is watching the plants slowly grow. I like seeing them.
What do you notice is happening as those plants get bigger and grow larger and start to flower?
I noticed that some of them, they're starting to grow like foods on them. And then the others are starting to grow and become flowers.
Anna, how about you?
I really like seeing the monarch butterflies and caterpillars.
So I understand that JMU students come over and help you garden too. And Mike, I was wondering if you could share what it is that you do with them when they show up at your school.
They will give us like milk jugs with holes in them at the bottom, and we would get to water the plants, and they teach us about the different kind of butterfly seeds and stuff.
And Principal Miller, what have you noticed with the interaction between the JMU students and the grade schoolers?
Yeah, our elementary students love it when the JMU kids come to help them out. A lot of them will be out there for their recess time, but they will kind of migrate towards the garden to help out. And talking to Amy, her students love that interaction too with our younger students. So it's a good interaction. It's a good relationship that that our students create with the JMU students.
Anna, what's your experience when the JMU students show up and help you garden?
Sometimes you go on scavenger hunts to look at for different plants and animals around the garden so we can get familiar with it. And sometimes you have different jobs, like one person might be planting, a few people might be planting, and other people might be watering.
And I just wonder if when you come back in the classroom after being in the garden, how do you feel then?
I kind of feel relaxed because it's like we get to look at all the stuff and there's butterflies flying around them and stuff. So I'm relaxed kind of.
So has it inspired you, either of you, to go home and garden at all?
Yeah, we have a lot of strawberries at our house. And every day we get a whole lot of them.
I have tomatoes, cucumbers, peppers, and sunflowers growing.
Oh, and I bet your sunflowers are getting ready to bloom.
Yeah, they're getting really big.
Well, Principal Miller, is there anything else that you would like to impart to us about the program today?
Yeah, the most feedback that I get and that I like the most is when a student comes up to me maybe on a Monday and they said, "Hey, Mr. Miller, I brought my family here to the garden and showed them what we are doing in the garden over the weekend and showed it interest." That's the feedback that I like the most is when students are using it outside the 8 to 3 hours here at Keister, is expanding it in the evenings and the weekends and showing their parents and their families and their friends kind of what they're working on is the feedback that I like the most.
I have always loved pollinators and I've always wanted to learn more about them. So it was really cool to see kids having a great time outside and discovering new insects. Kids would be terrified of ladybugs sometimes, but when you start to inform them that they're not harmful to you and that they're fun to play with and just the importance of different insects, it really changes the child's mindset and they want to be outside even more. So I always think it's a really good learning experience whenever they go outside and we are there.
Did they ever relate their experiences to you in a way that you knew they were having very unique experiences?
Yeah, Harrisonburg is a really unique place to go to these schools just because there's such a diversity of students from all over the world. So sometimes they might not be able to speak English to me, but yet we can still appreciate a beautiful flower. And sometimes you can pick between going to run around at recess or going to work in the garden. And kids will pick the garden, which is really cool because you know that they are learning and they're enjoying what they're doing in the garden, especially over the years watching it grow.
And how has your experience with the gardens influenced your life now and moving ahead away from JMU?
I still love environmental work and I'd love to do that in the future, but I want to turn it into more environmental educator aspect, helping children to see the wonders of the outdoors is what I'd like to do in the future. And I really credit that to being able to volunteer at the schools.
When I go into the garden, I like trying to find the hummingbirds.